No, God is good and his mercy endures forever. Can we give the Lord a hand clap of praise this morning? Amen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What a marvelous, wonderful God we serve. If we had 10,000 tongues, we couldn't thank him enough for all the wonderful benefits in our life. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Thank you.
I'm going to open up in prayer this morning, and I'm going to turn things over to Pastor Hart today. Your Sunday school, life-changing church, if you're in North Carolina, is the Holy Spirit is still present. Today's teaching in your Sunday school is the Holy Spirit is still present. If you want to please turn to your Bible, the 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and your regular service, the scripture that will be today, and the sermon is Love Lifted Me. Love Amen. Lifted Me. From Psalms chapter 40, verses 1 to 3, and your key verse will be verse 2. Sunday school, Holy Spirit is still present, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and your regular service, Love Lifted Me. From Psalms chapter 40, verse 1 to 3, and your key verse will be verse 2. Let's go to God in prayer this morning. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, as we thank you, as we praise you, as we magnify you, as we glorify your name, that's why our hearts are filled with praise. Lord, you said high, you look low, you're still the Alpha to the Omega, the beginning to the end, you're the first and the last, the only true wise and living God, and we're excited to have you in our presence. We invoke your presence into our service today,
yes,
God.
Yes, yes.
Just be with us. Come and sup with us. God, we ask you in Jesus' name, you'll fill this place to overflowing. Lord, we know that there's no building that can hold you. We know that you're everywhere,
Amen.
All the time inside of believers. So, God, wherever we are, that is our tabernacle today because we're fellowshipping together in the spirit of the living God. Lord, we have one faith, one Lord, one baptism, and we love you and praise you and magnify you. We ask you to touch the man of God as he brings forth the word
yes, Lord,
this morning
yes, yes.
in our Sunday school. And I pray you open up the minds of those that are here that they may understand
yes.
what the Spirit has to say to the church. And God, we praise you, we rebuke and bind you, Satan. You know you're around here somewhere, but we plead the blood
Amen.
Of Jesus against you right now. And we ask you, God, to please watch over us and keep us and fill us with understanding, fill us with knowledge. God, we're empty. We need you to fill us to overflowing. We thank you and praise you for this moment, this time, this second, that God is with us. And all these things we pray and give thanks to you, Jesus. To you, God, to you, Holy
yes.
Spirit, in Jesus' name, and everybody in the ministry said this morning, amen.
Amen.
Amen. And amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 12 as Pastor Hart begins to teach. The Holy Spirit is still present. And make sure that you're ready for regular service. I'll be in Psalm chapter 40, verse 1 to 3. And the key verse is 2, and your sermon today is Love Lifted Me. Your Sunday school is Holy Spirit is still present. God bless you. Let's get ready for a wonderful day. And do not forget, everybody, at 3 o'clock is the memorial service, is the memorial service for Mother Peterson. You don't want to miss that. Amen. Get your songs
Amen.
Ready, your testimony ready, your poems ready, because this day is going to be a day filled with the power of God in your life. The Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. And everybody say amen. All right, Pastor
amen.
Hart, you got it.
Amen, amen, amen. I like to say thank God for everybody that's on the line this morning. And I was thinking, getting ready for this lesson, that we had a very, very important teachings about many religions that were very interesting. And I talked about that quite a while during the last few days since I heard it. And the Holy Spirit is still present. It's a word that has to be presented at this hour because of all different kinds of religions as the teaching had told us about. And a very important thing, as I was getting ready, the Lord told me something, and he said Jesus has set everything up in order. And he did not leave it. My phone is echoing. Hold on just a minute.
Somebody needs to put the phone on mute. I hear ringing in the background. Put your phone on mute.
Hey, man, I hear ringing too.
Thank you.
Okay, is that better for everybody?
Stop for a minute. Let's make sure everybody puts your phone on mute so we can hear the speaker. We got a lot of people all over the world on this line, and all we ask you to do is just respectfully put your phone on mute so everybody can get word this morning. Amen? All right, Pastor Hart, let's roll.
Can everybody hear me now, brother?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Can everybody hear?
Amen.
Okay, all right. It do sound better. All right. As I was saying, that as getting ready, the Holy Spirit is still present. And that's a very important part of word that we must keep in our spirit. Jesus did not set up everything in order and leave it unattended. Remember when he was going back, he said he's going to send the Holy Spirit. And he shall lead us and guide us into all truth. I think about Jehovah Witness from time to time, and I sort of wondered about you could witness something. I know one witness that is in the earth. He's been to heaven already, and he came from heaven. Came down from heaven when Jesus was going up. He has seen the Father and the Son already, so he can witness because he done already seen. To what us Christians are looking forward to, and that's a strong saying. I just say it, but it's still true. It's a bad thing, even in the natural world, to go into a courthouse and try to witness something when you weren't there. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And close to our house. We have a power plant, and I listen to the power plant from time to time. When its power is in the air, a lot of time it leaves that sound. Mm-hmm. And the Holy Spirit, he's in power. He has the power of everything concerning Jesus' body. We are born again. He has power over our lives. Bible said, once we are born again, we are not our own because we have been bought with a price. Yeah. It's a whole lot the Bible states about. I'm going to pray a minute, and then we're going to begin at the pastor gave the scripture already. We're going to start at it. And I'd like to say this. We're going to only read a part of what I had wrote down because it's too much to try to get into one teaching. So it has to be a second part. Let's pray for a minute. Father God, in Jesus' name, we thank for the Holy Spirit this morning. Let the Holy Spirit speak through me because I have no words of my own. Even he did not come teaching concerning his own self. He come teaching to let us know about the Christ that have came down and died, and we are born again from him. The Bible says that we have been even washed by the word. Father God, I praise you this morning, and I thank you for everything that have been said up until this minute. Lord God, I thank you for the Holy Spirit. Spirit being on this line, he makes the whole thing about Jesus Christ. The man, I say again, that died for us. He came down to offer himself for ransom. I heard Paul say that he came to live and he died and rose again on the third day. And he rose again on the third day. He didn't say according to any man's writing or according to any angels talking. He said according to the scriptures. And everything that we teach and preach about Christ, it must be according to the scripture because Christ is the living word. I heard him say that he is the bread that came down from heaven. If we eat this bread, we shall live forever. He said we could drink the living water, as he told us the Samaritan woman. If you know who asked for water, you have gave him water, and he will give you living water. Lord God, I praise you today and I thank you. Continue to bless and set free on this line. I have no power of my own. For I heard you say that whatsoever we bound on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever we loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. In Jesus' name I pray. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let me do some reading some scriptures. We're going to hear something according to the scriptures, not according to my own understanding. What's written is written, cannot be changed. 12, it talks about spiritual gifts and offices. Let's see what Paul has to say about spiritual gifts. Spiritual gifts are given by the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit gives out these gifts. He knows our ability. The Bible says he gives gifts according to his will. And if he does it according to his will, it sort of takes my thoughts and my ways out of the way, because everything is done according to his will. He knows what everybody's able to handle. And he does something else with the gift that he gives us. That's why Satan pushes us from side to side concerning spiritual gifts, because a man asked me one day, and he said, how do you know what your gift is? If we walk close enough to the Spirit, he will show us our gift. And the Bible said that he will even show us a much more excellent way how to use it. And 1 Corinthians 12 says that, the first verse is that, now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I will not have you to be ignorant. Paul is saying that concerning spiritual gifts, he will not even cause us to be ignorant. He talked like people can be misled concerning gifts, and they can.
Amen.
And verse 2, let's read a little further. And you know that ye were Gentiles. We know that we were Gentiles. We ain't always been saved. Carried away by dumb idols. And hold on, teachings, if we're not careful, that we still end up carried away into dumb religions and dumb idols and things that God never said, never thought about. And that's going on a whole lot now. However you were led. He said that, however, many people end up there because they were led there. Verse 3. So that's why we have to be careful to what we talk about and what we teach. Because I find that even in my walk of life every day, I run into different people that witness for Christ and a lot of people that Lord even allows space for us to have a minute of prayer a lot of times that we talk about things concerning Christ and his body. Because I don't talk about scripture one day. I live that every day.
Amen.
Because it's one thing to talk about it, it's another thing to live in it.
Amen.
Verse 3. Let's read on a bit further. 1 Corinthians 12, chapter, verse 3. Therefore, and Paul is talking about gifts in this chapter. Therefore, I make known to you that no one speaking by the Spirit of Christ. Let's listen to that very careful. If you tell any man that forth I make known to you, that no one speaking by the Spirit of God calls Jesus a curse. We cannot be with him against him at the same time. We cannot, because if any man is born again, he cannot talk against Christ, because Christ is the one that lets him in to the Father. Because he said, no man cometh to the Father except by me. Christ even told us, even in the last book, he's the door that opens to let men into God. Yeah. That's a very proper thing. I cannot go into the Father on my own except I come through Christ.
Good God,
and I can't be born again talking against him, too.
Amen.
Anybody talking against them, they ain't for them. Y'all. Oh, my God. Amen. If they talking against them, they not for them. I'm sorry. That just was so clear. And that ought to be a lesson to everybody on the line.
Amen.
Anybody you deal with that talk against Christ is not in Christ.
Amen.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
My God.
Yeah.
A All right. I'm sorry. Y'all excuse that.
That's okay. Yeah, that's all right. Because we all on here to learn. Because we can't be with them against them at the same time. We're either hot or cold. I was drinking a cup of coffee a while ago, and it got a little warm. I had to go heat the thing back up again. And the Lord said that he would have us hot or cold. He would not have us lukewarm. No one can no one can say that Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Only way that we can even say that Jesus is Lord, it has to be through the Holy Spirit. So that we are, before this teaching is over, we're going to find out. We have some, because this is very important to say what I'm going to say, because we had some teaching not too long ago. Should people be baptized? I had a scripture in here that it talks about, yes, a person should, a person cannot come out of the world into the kingdom of God in the kind of way I'm hoping to explain that. Why should a person be baptized? Was not Jesus baptized? Jesus came from heaven, but he was baptized. He was baptized by John. John tried to talk him out of being baptized, but he told John it was written of him, it had to be so. Mm-hmm. If Jesus had to be baptized, we have to be baptized also. Let's answer that question.
Amen.
Let's read on to verse 4. I know I'm getting a little wild with it, but amen. It's still a part of it. Yes, we should be baptized, and because I asked the question a while ago, and I'm going to answer that question too, because it's in the lesson, but it won't be today. It talks about, should a man be born again? Yes, he should be born again. We're going to read about that too before the lesson's over. Let's read on a little bit further. Verse 4. There are the diversities of gifts, of many gifts, but the same Spirit. We're going to see in this lesson too that every gift has to be by the same Spirit. That's what the scripture is saying. Every gift is operated by the same Spirit, although it's a different gift. That we're talking about diversity of gifts. Many gifts in the same body. Let's get some understanding of what we're reading. There's many gifts from God, but it comes from the same spirit that's operating it, although it's a different gift. Although he used people in different ways. Verse 5. There are differences of ministries, but the same Lord. Saying the same thing. That there are many gifts, but the same God. Verse 6. And there are different diversities of activities. Some of our Bibles are going to read a little bit different. But it is the same God who works all in all. So that's answered the question what Paul was asking. Many gifts, but it's the same God that works all in all. So why is God working all in all with the same Spirit? Because the Bible says in God there's always order. If we're too many different spirits operating in the same body, something's going to get out of order. Is that not right? God is always order. Where there's always order, order is always power. We can take two people that can't come to one understanding about anything, we will lose power there. We have to be agreement before power comes in. Verse 7. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to each one to profit of all. Verse 8. If he give the gift to profit, he knows what he gave everybody, and he knows what everybody is able to handle. What is that trying to say to me? I don't even know in the body of Christ what I can handle myself. So I can't go through the body of Christ choosing gifts my own self. The Bible said gifts are given by the Spirit. He knows who will be able to profit, and he knows exactly where to put each and every one of us in the body of Christ. And I know one time that pastor told me when I first came, and he said that he had prayed about me being in the ministry. And he said that even first lady prayed too, and God gave both of them the same answer. We're both praying for the same thing, and God gave both of them the same answer at the same time. Verse 8. God keeps confusion out of body. That's what I'm trying to say. Verse 8. For to one is given the word of wisdom. Word of wisdom. Wisdom with the word. I mean, to one is given the word of wisdom. Take a long time for wisdom to come. Mm-hmm. Word of wisdom through the Spirit. To another, the word of knowledge. Mm-hmm. Through the same Spirit. Mm-hmm. He gives the word of wisdom and words of knowledge through the same Spirit. It's still another Spirit came in yet. He's doing it by the same Spirit. Mm-hmm. He's keeping it one-on-one. Verse 9. And this time, they're trying to say something to us, too. Before the church can roll on and stay on track with God, everybody has to come to one conclusion on everything that goes on in the body of Christ. You can have no disagreement. It has to be by one Spirit and has to stay in one order, and that's God's order.
Amen.
Amen.
To another, faith by the same Spirit. Faith by the same Spirit. As Jesus said, that he wonders he can find any still on earth when he comes. To another, the gifts of healing by the same Spirit. He's distributing some gifts here. But don't see, and here's something else I want to say concerning these gifts that the Bible is talking about here. God is not distributing his gifts just to be distributing. Whatever he gives us, we have to stay prayerful about it. Because, like I said, the thief is always after your gift. Mm-hmm. He don't care about anything but the gift that you have that is from God. He'll stop at nothing else to cost you to lose your ability and lose your gift. Gifts can't be taken also. Mm-hmm. He can even take that which you thought you had.
Mm-hmm.
To another, the working of miracles. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another prophecy is saying, is prophecy going to stay in the body of Christ to the perfect one come? All of these gifts is going to stay in place until the perfect one comes. When the perfect one comes, as the teacher was teaching the last lesson, when the perfect one comes, there is no need for none of these gifts that is naming here.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Because he's going to be the giver of gifts, and he's going to be the fulfiller of every gift that the Bible is talking about.
Amen.
But until he comes, these gifts are going to stay in the church, and they're going to stay in place, and the Holy Spirit is going to continue to set things in order until the perfect one comes. Because according to this teaching, that when things are set in order, it's done by the Spirit, not by man.
Amen.
Because it looks like a lot of time it'd be done by man. But a lot of people are moved by the Spirit, and God has told me whatever he used me to do is always going to be him. It's not going to be me.
Amen.
Even you take prophecy itself, it's a gift that is from God, and no man can see into time. It takes a God to do that.
Amen.
And he do it from time to time.
Mm-hmm.
In all prophecy is not lying prophets. Quite a number of them is. To another, discerning of spirits. Discerning of spirits. Because the discerning of spirits, I have told in time past, that discerning of spirits is a gift that many of us, if we don't have it yet, we should pray about it.
Amen.
because we have many teachers and preachers that God never even spoken to, and we have many other spirits. You remember starting off the lesson, Paul said many have been led off by dumb idols. Dumb idols getting easily mislead somebody, and anybody walking with God and have the Spirit of God, they should know the Spirit of God by the Spirit. Any person come teaching, walk with God and stay close to Him, and in prayer and in the Word of God. If any other spirit show up, the Holy Spirit he's gonna let you know about it. Why do we think the Bible says how can you hear without a preacher? How can he preach except he be sent? Mm-hmm. I heard Jesus said, "My sheep know my voice, and the strangers they will not follow." Discerning of spirits. And then it goes on to say, to another, different kinds of tongues. I can't say a whole lot against tongues because I'm still a tongue talker myself, even at prayer time. Most of prayer time. My private time, I talk to God. And I've been talking to Him in tongues so long, I understand what me and Him is talking about. And I know what He's saying to me. Although I will be honestly and correct with you, that took many, many years. To another interpretation of tongues. Interpretations of tongues, because you know what the tongues are saying, and you know what the Spirit is saying. And one thing that lets me know that I have the Spirit in my life, He talks to me more than about me than He do you. He talks to me concerning Scripture, and it tells me a long time. And He says, "I talk to you much concerning Scripture, not to make you big headed or smart, so that you'll know what I'm saying." Amen. He talks to me concerning Scripture. I know what He's saying. And not only He talks to me concerning Scripture, He tells me what the Scripture means.
Amen.
Because without Him telling me what it means, a whole lot of time, I'm going to be totally honest with you. I read what's on the page, and that's where I can go. Mm-hmm. Because the understanding is given by the Holy Spirit. And He set things in order.
Amen.
Verse 11, I'm going to start again at verse 11. But one, the self-same Spirit works all these things. Distributing to each one individual as He will. That goes as He will. He set things in order as He will.
Mm-hmm.
And He said nothing about a man running the church. The Holy Spirit runs the church. He set things in order according to chapter 12, verse 11. Said he set these things and distributed them as individual as He will.
Amen.
Verse 12. Well, as the body, it's going to seem like it's going to change a little bit. It's going to talk about the body. For as the body is one and has many members, but all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ.
Amen.
Because notice one thing about a body. Every part of your body works from the same brain. That's important, right? Because none of your pores ain't going to move except the brain sends a signal to one of your pores. Uh-oh. And that makes more sense then. Because your now part of your body going to move except that one brain sends a signal to it. I just kicked my foot, and my foot is not going to move except my brain just sent a signal to it.
Amen.
And, man, that's very important, to keep it. Keeping it remembers. Because if that one of them poor start moving out of order, it's something like what happened, right? Amen, amen. Very important. For by one Spirit, it's going back to the Spirit again. For by one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body. By one Spirit, we are all baptized in one body. It's saying, too, that we have to be baptized.
Mm-hmm.
Because we had some questions about that a while back. Yes, we have to be baptized. whether free or have been made to drink of one spirit. We're drinking of one spirit. We still operating by one spirit. Well, in a sense, in that same scripture, whether we are slaves or whether we are free, it's still by the same spirit. We all still drinking. We're all still receiving from the same spirit. We are following the same God. We are receiving from the same spirit. The same spirit, although it may work in, it causes, let me say this concerning one spirit. If we stay in the gift that God gave us, because I heard many, many singers, the one that God has gave a voice to I am telling you, some of them can't even sing good. But if the spirit is with them, if the spirit is with what they're doing, it makes the difference. Mm-hmm. It makes a difference. I'm going to say it again. It makes a difference.
Mm-hmm.
Because what I just said, whatever gift that he gave you, if you're using it in order, he gives you anointing. Mm-hmm. And something else that he does with that gift. The gift that he give you, if we be faithful and prayerful with it, he will make room for that gift. In the kingdom of God, he will make room for the gift. Verse 15. The foot should not say, because I am not a hand. This is explained by the brain. The foot can't say, because I am not the hand. I am not the other body. Every part of your body is a part of the body. And what makes it so outstanding about the body, even if any part of the body get a little scratch, all the rest of the body responds to it. Whatever happens to one part of it, the whole body responds. And it don't take a long time for the body to respond if something happens to one of the members. That's very important. If anything happens to any member of your body, all the rest of the body gonna hurry up and pay attention to that part.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 16. If the ear shall say, because I am not the eye. If the ear shall say, because I am not the eye, am I not a part of the body? Is it therefore not of the body? Yes, it is. Every part of your body has a responsibility to the body. The feet gonna keep you walking and balanced, and your eyes gonna keep you seeing what's in front of you, and you have taste, and you have hearing, and you have seeing. Every one of them pores has, by them being a member, they are not there just to be there. They are there for a purpose. And to hear the scripture say, eyes are not seen, nor ears heard, the thing that God has prepared for them that love him. They're called according to his purpose. Every part of the body, it has a purpose. Even so in the body of Christ, if you ain't the body of Christ, you have a purpose for being there. You're not there to just keep a seat warm. I heard the pastor say not too long ago that a good pastor knows that the gift that is in the house that is from God.
Amen.
How many of us remember him saying that?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
And it's not hard to notice either. When a gift comes about in the house of God, the man of God is going to know about it. You ain't got to go pushing on him, tell him, let you do this and let you do that. Because if that gift is properly prayed about and distributed, he going to ask you about the gift.
Amen.
Verse 20. Excuse me, verse 19. We're going to read verse 18. No, I have skipped the verse even now. Verse 18 said, Now God has set the members, each one of them in the body, as he pleased.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the Bible said as it had pleased him. Mm-hmm. But my understanding, just as he pleased.
Amen.
Verse 18. And if they were all one member, where would the body be? I was saying a while ago, if Amport get out of order concerning the body, we're in a bad fix.
Mm-hmm.
Concluding the church. If the members in the church start getting out of order, you're in a bad fix. Amen. Sometimes had to stop everything to get it back in order.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 20. But now indeed, there are many members, yet one body. Many members, but still one body. Verse 21. And the eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you. Nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you. All of them necessary, and all of them are very important. Verse 22. No, much rather, those members of the body which seem to be weaker are necessary. The weakest part of your body, the part that seems to be weakest, is very necessary. So what is that scripture trying to say? Really, in the body, there is no big you or little this and little that. Every part of the body that's in the church, every member of the part is necessary. Whether because you are not in front of everything, or if you're not always in the light, you are still necessary.
Mm-hmm.
That's why that when we have in church, I always let the children have a part, because they were necessary, and they still is today. They're still necessary.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna change scriptures a little bit. We're going to, let's go to Acts chapter 5, start with verse 1. We're going to see the importance of the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 5 and start with verse 1, Acts chapter 5. I'll give everybody a minute to get there. Acts chapter 5, verse 1. We're gonna see some things concerning the Holy Spirit in this chapter. The importance of
the Holy Spirit is still present. That is the
yeah. The Holy
Spirit is still present.
Amen. Amen. The Holy Spirit is still present. I was just checking my time because time is very important. Okay, Acts chapter 5, we're going to start with verse 1. It's going to talk about Ananias and Sapphira. This is very, very important. It's the Holy Spirit, because the same Holy Spirit is still present now. They were present in this chapter. We remember one scripture say you can talk against the Father, Son, but blasphemy against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven in this world, nor the world to come. That's a whole lot to say. Not even the world to come. That's a world that we haven't been. That's world to come that we haven't got to yet. That's important. So we have to be careful with what we're saying concerning the works of the Spirit. Verse chapter 5, verse 1. But a certain man named Ananias, which surprised his wife. What did they do? Did they sold a possession. Verse 2. And kept back part of the proceeds. His wife also being aware of it. Wife of grief. And bought a certain part and laid it at the apostles' feet. Bought a certain part and laid it at the apostles' feet. Let's see what else they had said about that certain part. Verse 3. Acts chapter 5, verse 3. But Peter said, Ananias, why have Satan filled your heart to lie to the Holy Spirit, to keep back part of the price of the land for yourself? Uh-oh, he has started lying already.
Lord have mercy.
It's a serious thing to be lying. That's why I was told years ago when I first started preaching. And I still said it in church, and I said it again this morning. If we're preaching and lying, we best to sit down until we stop lying.
Amen.
We can't be lying talking for God. Yeah. Even I have said in the past, I met a man had a name Apostle, which is a big name. And the man, he did all right when I first started. I stayed around a few days. Me and talked about Christ, and when the man told me he gonna do something very serious, and he didn't do it. And I called him, and he called me back a few times, even when I wasn't calling him, told me that he could meet me at a place. I got to the place, waited on him. The man never did show up. He had a lie every time that you asked him a question. And I was just meeting him, and as I told you, for me to be a man of God, it's a hard thing, because you have to keep your sayings. And my name get to the job before I do. I have a big job to do when I get there, because I have been told by word of mouth that I can do this and I can do that. It's been because me and the guy was laughing the other day. I got there and a guy just seen me over there in this man's yard, and they said, "Well, you got the right man there." And I just found the job. They made my job hard.
Amen.
They made my job hard. Right then. Because the man hollered with a witness over there. The man Wolf was a witness that put me in a place I hadn't got to yet.
Amen.
So let's be careful with our words. I always said that if you tell anybody you can do anything, if you can't do it. Don't leave it undone. Call them and tell them why you couldn't do what you say you can do.
Yes.
Because
and
a lion
ain't got you yet.
If a man can't tell the truth for all truth for God, there's something wrong with that.
Amen.
That's one witness. A man keep his sayings, because God keep all his.
Amen.
Let's read on a little further. Let's see what else Peter had to say here. Verse 3. But Peter said, Ananias, why have Satan filled your heart? Satan filled his heart to lie to the Spirit. He still do the same today. Satan still fill our hearts to try not to get us to mess up our witness. Any person mess up, what am I saying a while ago? If your witness is messed up, you don't have to sit down a while. Because people is not going to listen to no two-way thing. And they know you're lying, you know, because I heard the word of God says a offended brother is harder to win than a strong city. Verse 4. And we see in verse 3 that Satan had fear Ananias' heart to lie against the Spirit. Verse 4. Why Peter still talking here, and why it remained, was it still not your own? And after it was sold, was it not your own, was in your own control before it was sold? Why have you received this thing, conceived this thing in your heart? You have not lied to men, but to God. Serious. Verse 5. Then Ananias, hearing these words, fell down and breathed his last. So great fear came on all those who heard these things.
They better.
Getting tough. Great fear. Verse 6. Acts 5 and verse 6. The young men arose and wrapped him up. He fell down, and the young man hurried up and rose and wrapped him up, carried him out and buried him. That's serious. Verse 7. Now it was about the third hour. Now it was about 3 hours later when his wife came in, not knowing what had happened. Verse 8. Mm-hmm. Somebody just coming on the line. We are in Acts 5, verse 8.
Thank you.
Talk about the Holy Spirit is still present.
Amen.
Acts 5, verse 8. And Peter answered her, tell me whether you sold the land for so much. She said yes for so much. She agreed with her husband. Then Peter said to her, how is it that you have agreed together to test the Spirit of the Lord? Look, the feet of those who have buried your husband are at the door. They will carry you out. Amen. Verse 10 says, then immediately she fell down at his feet and breathed her last. And the young man came in and found her dead, and carrying her out, buried her by her husband. That's not serious. And verse 11 says that after all this happened, verse 11 says, for great fear came on all the church and upon all who heard these things. That should tell us something about tempting the Spirit of God or lying concerning the Spirit of God.
Yeah.
Let's keep our word. I have one more scripture I'm going to read concerning this today, and then I'll be on time. Let's turn to Matthew's 3:16 and 17. Let's see what God had to say about Jesus being baptized. Matthew 3, verse 16 and 17. If Jesus had to be baptized, then we had to be baptized. And Jesus, God's son, he set an example. God has set an example through his son, and the son came down and did everything that he said he was going to do, and went back and fulfilled everything that he came for. Through obedience, even humbling himself, even unto death. And he was baptized also. So this is going to answer our question what we had a while back. Matthew 3, I'm going to read verse 16. Matthew 3, verse 16 is talking about Jesus' baptism. When he had been baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water. And behold, the heavens were open to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove upon like a dove and lighting upon him. Very important. I'm going to say that. Remember when John said he that sent him told him whoever he see the Spirit coming down on and remain on him, he was the one that's going to baptize with the Holy Ghost. And it did. And John said that he come to baptize with water, but Christ was the one that's going to baptize with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yeah.
Verse 17. And immediately a voice came from heaven saying, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. Well, what an interesting thing about this reading. Soon as John baptized Jesus, soon as the Spirit of God came down on him, the heavens opened up, and God spoke out of the cloud and said, "This is a witness to what was happening." God testified his own self. This is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. And I'm going to read something very important to our lesson. We're going to read on down into Matthew 4. A couple of verses, and then I'm going to turn over to the pastor. If we had to be led by the Spirit, Jesus himself was led by the Spirit, according to the scripture. Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by Satan. What the scripture was saying, that after Jesus was baptized, he was immediately led by the Spirit into the wilderness. The scripture did not say that Jesus went on his own into the wilderness. Jesus was led by the Spirit. He was led by the Spirit immediately after he was baptized. And the scripture says that also to us, those that are led by the Spirit are the sons of God. if the Holy Spirit is still present. Yes, the Holy Spirit is still present right today. And the Holy Spirit is still doing exactly everything that he came for. He came to baptize with fire. He came to lead us and guide us into all truth. And the Bible said that he to lead us into all truth, and he will comfort us. He will never leave us or forsake us. Yes. Even now when I pass the funeral home, when the sign is full, I say a real quick prayer immediately. I ask the Lord to let the God, the Holy Spirit, comfort all those that need comforting. So that is a time that only the Spirit, man can say all the words he wants to say, and it still don't seem like it's enough.
Amen.
The Spirit has to do a work concerning death. And I thank God for this moment today to speak into the lives of men that have came on the line, and I'm gonna stay on time, and I'm gonna turn the service back over into the hands of the pastor after prayer.
I got a question, Jesus' name.
Yes.
Hey, this is Brother Manny. Good morning. You said
how you get baptized.
You said Jesus was baptized with the Holy Ghost and the fire. How did you get baptized with fire?
Through the Holy Spirit. The fire the Bible is talking about here, it's talking about the fire from the Holy Ghost. Did I answer that right?
Not really.
Let's our statement scripture. Remember, John says that he baptized only with water.
Right.
But there coming one after him that will come baptized with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Okay.
Because the Bible said after we receive the Holy Ghost, then shall we have power. Because in my own walk with God, I would say this, give a little bit better understanding. I was baptized in water first. And then I was standing at the altar after prayer one day, and then the Holy Spirit came on me, you know, because I know in the kingdom of God, because some be laid hands on and receive the Holy Spirit speaking in tongues as the Spirit give utterance. But I have seen God save people and nobody even touched them, and they come through with speaking in tongues. Did they receive salvation and the gift of speaking in tongues at the same time? It was all done by the work of the Spirit. It was not done by man. Because what am I trying to say? God gave them the Holy Spirit without anybody even touching them. And he done the same thing with me.
Okay.
Because
my experience when I caught the Holy Ghost.
Yes, yes. We have minutes, so yes, go ahead.
When I caught the Holy Ghost, I was at church, and it was on my wedding day. And, you know, I prayed about this the whole night before. You know, God gave me that Holy Ghost. And so I was in church, I was doing my own little thing, and I don't know what happened. I heard something, like it was something that just triggered me, and then next thing you know, I felt like I got smacked in the face by fire, like heat, and it knocked me down where I was bent over, looking at the floor, and I couldn't put my hands down, and I couldn't stop saying hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah over and over again, and I was drooling. So when you were saying the Holy Spirit and the Holy Ghost and that fire, like, to me, from my experiences, I felt like the fire came because it felt like I literally got smacked in the face by a ball of fire. It was so hot, and I couldn't understand it. And I just couldn't understand it. So that was my experience.
Sister Bridget.
Yes, and let me say this quickly about the fire part. And the Bible says that the fire from the Holy Ghost, he burns off the shaft. The fire burns off the shaft. Shaft is past works in our lives, and shaft can also be weights that is on our life. Because we have different experiences. Every one of us could testify that do have the Holy Spirit. It might be a different way, but it still be the same Spirit.
Understand. So question. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Okay, because we're going to have some different experiences with the same Spirit. Okay. What do I mean by different experiences? I'm going to tell you so. Tell you what I mean. Because the Bible says he does things according to his will.
His will, not ours.
He sets, right? Uh-huh. He set different, because he might carry all of us a different way, but it can be the same Spirit and it can be according to his will.
Amen.
Because why do God feel some at the same time that they get saved? It's according to his will. Mm-hmm. It is not the will of man. Mm-hmm. When it comes down to our salvation, it couldn't have been bought by a normal man. Mm-hmm. That's why Christ had to come. And open and say the prayer. Another couple of seconds. Let me pray so I can stay in time. Father God, in Jesus' name, I praise you and I thank you for everybody that even had a question on the end. Because their questions are very important. Lord God, I pray that we'll stay humble and do the thing that God has in front of us and be led by his Spirit and walk in his Spirit, that we would not fulfill the lust of the flesh. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
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 God bless y'all this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus,
Amen.
For this great opportunity.
Amen.
If all of us be on the line together, we know today is a very, very spirit-filled day.